say. And that's a pretty profound thing, actually, to go on a manic depressant. It's tough to get off, etc. So when you talk about prescribing, in my opinion, psychiatric drugs in primary care, you really want to see if there's any way to do it a bit more judiciously and with some breaks on it. You spoke earlier about you get the people after they've gone through three iterations. Didn't I get that right?
So yes.
In other words, you're getting a lot of people that didn't go well for it, in essence, right?
Yes.
By the time they get to you. Anyway, I just think in primary care right now, the way that they're just handed out without any sense that this is sort of a profound thing to put the person on the psychiatric drug. Second, look, it's one.
Right.
She's raising a really important point here, and that is the short-term efficacy of these meds might be very different from the long-term efficacy of these meds. There's that question. Also, on antidepressants, if you look at who they're tested in, they're tested in those with severe depression, right? Mm-hmm. The Hamilton scores are generally above 20 and all. At least there's a lot of debate on whether there's any efficacy over placebo in the mild to moderate. So many people coming in for that primary care, they're not really in that severe category. So you even have a short-term evidence base in that primary care. So I guess what I'm saying is I think right now drugs are prescribed in primary care settings in a very sort of flip manner, as we put it, without really assessing all the questions you just brought up and really knowing the literature and all these other questions. And I think it's a profound thing to go on and leave.
I don't think they're